I regretted it. I even thought I'll find somehow ways to send the bike back to Delhi and go home. Vada rest eduk vandu odikkavanda na inna full rest naale ivide nan aduthulla saram vela nokkiittu hotel eduthittu mari ha ha light varan light varan okay rendu sir ninnittu palaga vannai okay okay bro. Good morning people, day 5 of the ride. There's been a slight change of plans. I'm riding solo to Manali and then from Manali to Spiti and Spiti to Leh, and only in Leh I'll be joined by my friend. So will I take Spiti alone, especially in the recent times there have been many landslides and all that, and Spiti is not safe to travel alone, because if this gadi falls once with all the luggage, I'll not be able to get it back up again. So I don't know, only one way to find out after I reaching Manali, I have to speak to a bunch of people and get to know how difficult it is. Anyway, this is my first solo trip in like 2 years, I think, other than the Chikmagalur after training camp. Little worried, little tense, little scared. We'll see. We have joined the highway. Getting out of Delhi city was easy, I think, because I started early, woke up at 5 and then started riding at 6, so I think that made the difference. This will be the longest longest ride of our journey. I told that the longest would be Hyderabad, no, Nagpur to Jhansi. Yes, that is the longest in kilometers. Even Manali, the Delhi Manali is close to that, but only issue is towards Manali is we start to climb the hills. So hills you can't go as fast like this, like in 100 km per hour or so, maximum 30-40. So according to Google Maps, it will take 12 hours to reach. So I should reach by 6 in the evening, but I hand it out, so I have it out that we'll reach. So I doubt that we'll reach by 6. Most probably by 8 or 9. I hope I make it safe. Sun is up. Golden hour, looking good.
Google is taking me through an alternative route that is supposed to be 50 minutes lower than the highway, but only issues in one exit to the highway, police blocked me and told me to go back and hit another road. I mean, that is this road. The thing is, because it is Independence Day today, there is tight security all over the city and all the entry points to the city, so I think that is why they have blocked all the exit points. Now I thought 50 minutes lower, that would be good, it will save me some time. But now I wish I should have taken the highway. I wouldn't have to face all the security issues and then... Anyway, let's see. If I'm not able to get out of the city into the highway at any exit point, I have to go back all the way where I took this TV. That's like almost 10 kilometers now. And then take the highway. Oh my god, I wish that doesn't happen. Highway is supposed to be another 500 meters ahead. I hope even that exit is not blocked by the police. Please don't be. These are the farmers' protestants. Yeah. These are the farmers' protests. Wow, there are so many of them. Oh, no wonder Google took me to this alternative route. All these highways are blocked by these farmers' tents. See that? Wow. Seem to be relatively empty.
Took a break now. Fill up the tank and bring some water. Riding continues from 6 in the morning. It is. Oops. Okay. It is 101 kilometers to Chandigarh. I'm riding as fast as possible to reach Chandigarh as soon as possible. So that I can take my own time in climbing the hills to Manali. I really want to make it before sunset. I don't know if I can make it, but I'm trying my level best. So mostly today there will be no hotel breaks, only roadside breaks for breakfast and lunch. Because I'm riding solo, I have the freedom to take breaks whenever I want, and but it feels weird after 4 days of riding with him, and now suddenly he's not there. I don't have anyone to look into the mirror and see if he's coming or not. Feels weird, definitely, and I will be recovered. More on that later. Otherwise, weather seems to be okay, 39 degrees. The moment I start sweating. Yesterday, actually, when I was discussing this thing with him, he only told me, because of my visor, I'm not getting any wind. That is why in this heat, even though I'm riding at 100 km per hour, I'm still sweating. If I had removed the visor, I would not sweat much. But on the other hand, if I remove the visor, the wind blast will be too much that I have to hold and sit tight for the entire stretch. That will take a toll on my body as well. Today morning I woke up with severe back pain. I woke up even before my alarm went off. So I had to take a painkiller, and then right now it is a little bit relieved. I think the painkiller is kicking in. So yeah, I'll remove the, most probably I'll remove the visor after Manali, so that I can enjoy the view of the mountains as well as you can.
Took a small deviation from the highway just to have a little bit of breakfast. I'll give you guys a context of what happened actually. Principal Chetan, who was riding with me on his first ride from Trivandrum to Bangalore, he rode for almost like 2 or 3 hours straight. And then that was the first time he was riding such a long distance. So muscles in his hand got cramped up. And he was not able to hold his hand, I mean hold anything, the right hand especially. So it got clawed up, like some kind of claw hand like this, hold an accident like this, and his hand completely clawed up. He thought initially after 1 hour, it will go up. Even I thought so. So even when he came to Bangalore, he had a tough time eating with his hands because it was completely clawed up like this. Not much of pain, but he cannot move or he cannot straighten the fingers. So what he did is, but we kept riding. We thought it was okay, took some painkillers, anti-inflammatory stuff and all. It kept getting worse and worse and worse to a point where I had to tear rotis for him, shred out the chicken pieces for him and all that. And he could not carry his luggage. It became very worse. And yesterday when we reached Delhi, it completely clawed up to a point where he had to manually, do this to fingers to release from the joints. So his friend, physiotherapist in Delhi, told him to take rest for 1 week. But obviously we cannot do that. So what he told is true. Once you reach Manali, because of the cold temperature, it will get worse to a point where even for normal people, when you are riding through the cold winds, your hands will become stiff. So his hands are already stiff, and if he rides cold temperature, it will become fully stiff, and he will not be able to continue further. And if something happens along the way, you know the scene. Because now you can't get much help there. So we decided to take a break for 3 days, do physiotherapy sessions. So we came up with a plan. I am riding solo all the way to Manali and from there to Spiti solo. I'm literally very scared, very tense of how it might be. I used to go solo all the time 2 years back. That was my previous gaadi. I trusted it. It never gave me any hiccup and it was much lighter than this one. But if this gaadi, if it even falls for one moment, I don't think I'll ever be able to pick it up with all this luggage and all this stuff. So that's going to be a task. So what I'm thinking is I'll go to Manali, ask around if it's safe to travel to Spiti, especially with the recent landslides and all that. If it is not, I'll stay in Manali till he comes and cancel our Spiti, or I'll ride Spiti alone, join him in Leh. So he's completely cutting out Spiti from the itinerary and coming directly to Manali and then to Leh. That's a plan right now. Hopefully he recovers. And hopefully I get to go to Spiti. Fingers crossed. So today I'm not taking any hotel break, continuously riding and taking breaks like this. Okay, took a short break, after a peanut butter sandwich and an apple, I feel awesome. So I think another 90 kilometers to Chandigarh. I just called the infield service center in Manali. Apparently there is no booking for service, like how usually a RLP service works. What that manager told me is that you can come by 9:30, drop the bike for oil change and all everything, and it's on a first come first serve basis. So they'll give everything, because they are like many riders come from many parts of the place. India at a different timing, so they don't want to keep appointments. Fair enough, it's a good point. So just like 9:30 you come off, have
last message shop opens. Keep everything service, fadafat. And somebody is fadafat and it can go. Seems good. So a lot of things to do in Manali tomorrow. First is a service. Second is Dubai, pack up some food. To cook on the way. Then buy long boots. And if possible, do an RT-PCR test also. 9:15 a.m. Starting to get a little bit warm. Have to cover as much as possible before it gets really hot. Once it gets hot, you have to take frequent breaks. That's the issue.
I exited the highway and turned towards Chandigarh. I miss going at 100 km per hour on that highway. It seems to be a smaller road to Chandigarh. Almost nearing Chandigarh city. Now it's 10 in the morning. I have to get into the Manali route and then take a break, so that I can escape all this city traffic. Oops.
This is by far the farthest point in North India I've come. Ever. I have to on a motorcycle. One day I have to come to Punjab to visit Amritsar, Ludhiana, Wagha border and all that. I wish we had time to do all that. Manali! First time aboard from Manali. Yes! We are on the right track.
Cycle rally, poor lorry rally. Here it is. This is the tractor rally. Tractor rally. I don't know where these guys are headed to, but it looks nice. All tractor rally playing, all Punjabi songs. Oh my God, it's never ending. There's so many of them. Are they going to some protest or what? Independence Day, right? Then maybe they're protesting for Azadi. Looks like a protest.
Whenever there's a clearing on the trees, I'll be like, can we see the Himalayas here? Can we see the Himalayas here? Still no sign of the mountains. 50 kilometers more to go. Manali.
Okay. I see signs of the mountains.
I don't know if the camera can pick up that. This is what we came for, baby. Yes, mountains.
Oh, man! Oh, see those mountains. Oh, for this we traveled 5 days, man. In hot weather. Oh my God, finally in mountains. Wait to start the ascent. So what has happened is in the excitement of seeing the mountains, I took a wrong turn and got halfway through it the wrong way actually. So now I have to travel 44 kilometers to reach the Manali highway. Oh my god. Shit. Just because I was excited about the mountains. Don't do this stupid mistake, guys. Seriously. This is how the road is gonna be. 45 kilometers is going to take 1 hour. For my vaccination certificate. So I showed them, they approved it and let me go. That's good. Hill climb has begun. But there is no sign to any relief from the heat in Manali 217. Winding roads are never ending. Still 180 more kilometers to Manali. And I am dead tired. Dead tired. No wonder people tell it's very difficult to cover Delhi Manali in one stretch. So they stop at Chandigarh and then go to Manali. I thought 500 kilometer was a big deal. This is a big deal. I'm covering 1 kilometer in every like 6-7 minutes. Whereas it used to be less than a minute in the highway. And the main thing, so the roads are really, really bad. Everywhere potholes and gutters. Let's see. Had a quick lunch from here. Some roti and paneer curry. And now we are off. 180 kilometers to Manali. Google says it'll take around 6.5 hours. Per hour, I can cover only like 40 kilometers or so. It's still very hot, very, very hot. I hope I can make it before sunset. Really, man, I really, really hope. And just lie in bed for 2 continuous days. I'm beginning to realize that this whole planning thing was a mistake, actually. We thought 500 kilometers every day. Continuously for a piece of cake, but no. Bodies are taking a big toll beyond even what we can imagine. I'm trying to keep my eyes open. I'm that much drowsy. On 90 kilometers to Manali and the roads are pretty much going to be like this the entire time. Oh man, I cannot even imagine. I wish at least the climate would have been better. I mean, weather would have been better. Look at those mountains. Beautiful, isn't it?
Wow! Oh! Oh, side of it! First side of the road, Himalayan river. Wow, exploding. Oh, after hours and hours and hours of riding, one such sight boosted my morale so much. I was about to give up. Oof. Shit, tired. Oh, yes, baby. Yes, 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 yes. Mandi Kulu Manali.
Wow. Just wow. Wow. That was nice. Ah, 135 kilometers to Manali and 94 to Kulu. But it suddenly became very dark out here. It's just 2:30 in the evening. 2:30 in the afternoon to be precise. But it's very dark now. I don't know. I hope it doesn't rain. Weather has turned a little bit cool now. Little bit, not much. In the sense that if I stop again, I'll sweat. So I'm not stopping even though I'm very thirsty right now. It's getting very, very windy. Look at that rain clouds over there. I hope it doesn't rain, man. It's the last thing I want to have. Oh my god! Jacket is brown color. Just take a look at that. Oh my god. I've never seen a dark and creepy mountain bridge ever before. Wow. Oh my god, there's thunder.
My prayers got finally answered. After 5 days of riding through intense heat, the temperature dropped to a point where I could finally enjoy the ride. Even at 4 in the evening, the daylight started fading and so did my hope of reaching Manali before sunset. Towards Manali, the roads became worse and worse, almost to a point where it was an off-road experience. To make things worse, there was a landslide earlier that day on the highway. Without knowing it, I drove straight into the clearing area. There was no way out but to wait till the entire highway stretch was cleared. Just as I parked my bike at a fair distance away from the clearing area, a fresh pile of rocks came tumbling down the hill towards the clearing area. People who were watching the clearing process quickly ran to take cover. Luckily, no one got hurt. The workers, with the help of JCB, broke the big boulders to smaller parts and pushed them down the hill to the river below. Half hour to 45 minutes later, they let us pass through. Not even a kilometer ahead, there was another landslide clearing that was going on and a huge traffic jam with it. the locals showed me and the other bikers an alternate route to get to Manali. It was a much narrower route than the highway, but still we decided to take it. Even though the route had almost zero traffic and amazing view of the hills, I was getting nervous as it was getting dark quite fast and it was completely deserted. It seemed there was absolutely no end to this route and no signboard to tell me how close I was to Manali.
Manali is there?
Sir, left, you know.
Oh yeah, thanks, mate.
After almost an hour of winding through the hills, I finally joined the Manali highway, only to realize I've just come 5 kilometers far from the traffic jam from where I took a detour. Even though the views were amazing, the road till Kulu was very bad. It was filled with mud, slush and potholes owing to the tunnel construction that is going on in many places. The road from Kulu to Manali was amazing. The views were simply beautiful and my ride was blessed with the sunset over the mountains.
Would you like, dude, you just look at that, man. Snow cape mountains for the first time in my life, I'm seeing it with my own eyes. Oh my god. I was so damn dead tired. I even regretted of doing this Delhi Manali trip in one day. I thought I'll not do this anymore. I regretted it. I even thought I'll find somehow ways to send the bike back to Delhi and go home. That much I was tired. My every body part is aching. The knees, my hands, my face, my back, everything. I so regretted this. But I just, as soon as I saw that snow-capped mountains, everything just went away. I never thought I'll see something like this coming on my own bike all the way from home. I'm so happy. Oh. It's beautiful. Yeah, you have no idea how much I want to go back. The road was horrible. There was a landslide. And a detour of 1 hour. But this is... it was worth it, man. It was worth it. Okay. Enough of me getting emotional. Let's get to work. God, oh my god, oh my god, oh my god, oh my god, wow, wow,
wow.
मैं एड्रेस बताता हूँ आपको. मोनो टेंपल रोड.
मनु
टेंपल रोड.
ओल्ड मनाली से फारिश हेड आपको मनाली पहुंच करके वो फारिश हेड वो दिखती है.
हां उधर जाना है.
हां बस इसी के मेन रोड पे जाइए ना.
हां
उसके ऊपर से आप राइट साइड को डाल दीजिए.
राइट साइड को. ठीक है ठीक है. थैंक यू. जास्टल के बारे में. जास्टल बाइक जाएंगे. Thanks, bhai. Oh my god, it's a shitty place. Hostel is in a very shady place. Okay. That's it for today, guys. I'll see you tomorrow. Tomorrow we have a lot of work to do. Get the gaadi serviced, acclimatize, do some shopping for basic food items, get to know about Spiti. And now it's everything. Oh, this is beautiful. Till then, goodbye. See you tomorrow.